The Slave Trade, a poem by Hannah Moore. If heaven has into being deigned to call thy light, O liberty, to shine on all, bright intellectual sun, why does thy ray to earth distribute only partial day? Since no resisting cause from spirit flows thy penetrating essence to oppose. No obstacles by nature's hand impressed, thy subtle and ethereal beams arrest. Nor motion's laws can speed thy active course, nor strong repulsion's powers obstruct thy force. Since there is no convexity in mind, why are thy genial beams to parts confined? While the chill north with thy bright ray is blessed, why should fell darkness half the south invest? Was it decreed, fair freedom, at thy birth, that thou shouldst ne'er irradiate all the earth? While Britain basks in thy full blaze of light, why lies sad Africa quenched in total night? Thee only, sober goddess, I attest, in smiles chastised and decent graces dressed. Not that unlicensed monster of the crowd, whose roar terrific bursts in peals so loud, deafening the ear of peace, fierce faction's tool, of rash sedition born and mad misrule, whose stubborn mouth, rejecting reason's reign, no strength can govern and no skill restrain, whose magic cries the frantic vulgar draw to spurn at order and to outrage law, to tread on grave authority and power and shake the work of ages in an hour. Convulsed her voice and pestilent her breath, she raves of mercy while she deals out death. Each blast is fate. She darts from either hand, red conflagration o'er the astonished land. Clamouring for peace, she rends the air with noise, and to reform a part the whole destroys. O plaintive southerner whose impassioned strain so oft has waked my languid muse in vain. Now when congenial themes her cares engage, she burns to emulate thy glowing page. Her failing efforts mock her fond desires. She shares thy feelings, nor partakes thy fires. Strange power of song, the strain that warms the heart seems the same inspiration to impart. Touched by the kindling energy alone, we think the flame which melts us is our own. Deceived for genius, we mistake delight. Charmed as we read, we fancy we can write. Though not to me, sweet bard, thy powers belong, fair truth, a hallowed guide, inspires my song. Here art would weave her gayest flowers in vain, for truth the bright invention would disdain. For no fictitious ills these numbers flow, but living anguish and substantial woe. No individual griefs my bosom melt, for millions feel what Orinoco felt. Fired by no single wrongs the countless host, I mourn by rapine dragged from Africa's coast. Perish the illiberal thought which would debase the native genius of the sable race. Perish the proud philosophy which sought to rob them of the powers of equal thought. Does then the immortal principle within change with the casual colour of a skin? Does matter govern spirit, or is mind degraded by the form to which 'tis joined? No, they have heads to think and hearts to feel, and souls to act with firm though erring zeal. For they have keen affections, kind desires, love strong as death and active patriot fires. All the rude energy, the fervid flame of high-souled passion and ingenuous shame. Strong but luxuriant virtues boldly shoot from the wild vigour of a savage root. Nor weak their sense of honour's proud control, for pride is virtue in a pagan soul. a sense of worth, a conscience of desert, a high unbroken haughtiness of heart. That self-same stuff which erst proud empires swayed, of which the conquerors of the world were made. Capricious fate of man! That very pride in Africa scourged, in Rome was deified. No muse, O Quashy, shall thy deeds relate, no statue snatch thee from oblivious fate. For thou wast born where never gentle muse on valour's grave the flowers of genius strews. And thou wast born where no recording page plucks the fair deed from time's devouring rage. Had fortune placed thee on some happier coast, where polished souls heroic virtue boast, to thee who soughtest a voluntary grave, the uninjured honours of thy name to save, whose generous arm thy barbarous master spared, altars had smoked and temples had been reared. Whenever to Africa's shores I turn my eyes, horrors of deepliest, deadliest guilt arise. I see by more than fancy's mirror shown, the burning village and the blazing town. See the dire victim torn from social life, the shrieking babe, the agonizing wife. She, wretch forlorn, is dragged by hostile hands to distant tyrants sold in distant lands. Transmitted miseries and successive chains, the sole sad heritage her child obtains. Even this last wretched boon their foes deny, to weep together or together die. By felon hands, by one relentless stroke, see the fond links of feeling nature broke, the fibres twisting round a parent's heart, torn from their grasp and bleeding as they part. Hold, murderers, hold, not aggravate distress. Respect the passions you yourselves possess. Even you of ruffian heart and ruthless hand, love your own offspring, love your native land. Ah, leave them holy freedom's cheering smile, the heaven-taught fondness for the parent soil. Revere affections mingled with our frame, in every nature, every clime the same. In all, these feelings equal sway maintain, in all the love of home and freedom reign, and temples veil and parched Angola's sand, one equal fondness of their sons command. The unconquered savage laughs at pain and toil, basking in freedom's beams which gild his native soil. Does thirst of empire, does desire of fame, for these our specious crimes, our rage inflame? No, sordid lust of gold their fate controls, the basest appetite of basest souls. Gold better gained by what their ripening sky, their fertile fields, their arts and mines supply. What wrongs, what injuries does oppression plead to soothe the horror of the unnatural deed? What strange offence, what aggravated sin? They stand convicted of a darker skin. Barbarians, hold, the opprobrious commerce spare, respect his sacred image which they bear. Though dark and savage, ignorant and blind, they claim the common privilege of kind. Let malice strip them of each other plea, they still are men, and men should still be free. Insulted reason loathes the inverted trade, dire change, the agent is the purchase made. Perplex the baffled muse involves the tale, nature confounded, well may language fail. The outraged goddess with abhorrent eyes sees man the traffic, souls the merchandise. Plead not in reason's palpable abuse, their sense of feeling callous and obtuse. From heads to hearts lie nature's plain appeal, though few can reason, all mankind can feel. Though wit may boast a livelier dread of shame, a loftier sense of wrong refinement claim. Though polished manners may fresh wants invent, and nice distinctions nicer souls torment, though these on finer spirits heavier fall, yet natural evils are the same to all. Though wounds there are which reason's force may heal, there needs no logic sure to make us feel. The nerve, however untutored, can sustain a sharp, unutterable sense of pain. As exquisitely fashioned in a slave as where unequal fate a scepter gave. Sense is as keen where Congo's sons preside as where proud Tiber rolls his classic tide. Rhetoric or verse may point the feeling line. They do not whet sensation but define. Did ever slave less feel the galling chain when Zeno proved there was no ill in pain? Their miseries, philosophic quirks deride, slaves groan in pangs disowned by stoic pride. When the fierce sun darts vertical his beams, and thirst and hunger mix their wild extremes. When the sharp iron wounds his inmost soul, and his strained eyes in burning anguish roll. Will the parched Negro find, ere he expire, no pain in hunger and no heat in fire? For him, when fate his tortured frame destroys, what hope of present fame or future joys? For this have heroes shortened nature's date, for that have martyrs gladly met their fate. But him, forlorn, no hero's pride sustains, no martyr's blissful vision soothe his pains. Sullen he mingles with his kindred dust, for he has learnt to dread the Christian's trust. To him what mercy can that power display, whose servants murder and whose sons betray? Savage thy venial error, I deplore. They are not Christians who infest thy shore. O thou sad spirit whose preposterous yoke the great deliver death at length has broke. Released from misery and escaped from care, go meet that mercy man denied thee here. In thy dark home, sure refuge of the oppressed, the wicked vex not and the weary rest. And if some notions vague and undefined of future terrors have assailed thy mind, if such thy masters have presumed to teach, as terrors only they are prone to preach, for should they paint eternal mercy's reign, where the oppressor's rod the captive's chain? If then thy troubled soul has learnt to dread the dark unknown thy trembling footsteps tread, on him who made thee what thou art depend. He who withholds the means accepts the end. Not thine the reckoning dire of light abused, knowledge disgraced and liberty misused. On thee no awful judge in sense shall sit for parts perverted and dishonoured wit. Where ignorance will be found the surest plea, how many learned and wise shall envy thee? And thou, white savage, where the lust of gold or lust of conquest rule thee uncontrolled, hero or robber, by whatever name thou plead thy impious claim to wealth or fame, whether inferior mischiefs be thy boast, a petty tyrant rifling Gambia's coast, or bolder carnage track thy crimson way, kings dispossessed and provinces thy prey, panting to tame wide earth's remotest bound, all Cortes murdered, all Columbus found, or plunders realms to reign, detested lord, make millions wretched and thyself abhorred. In reason's eye and wisdom's fair account, your sums of glory boasts a like amount. The means may differ, but the end's the same. Conquest is pillage with a nobler name. Who makes the sum of human blessings less, or sinks the stock of general happiness? No solid fame shall grace, no true renown, his life shall blazon or his memory crown. Had those adventurous spirits who explore through ocean trackless wastes the far-sought shore, whether of wealth insatiate or of power, conquerors who waste or ruffians who devour, had these possessed, O cook, thy gentle mind, thy love of arts, thy love of humankind. Had these pursued thy mild and liberal plan, discovers had not been a curse to man. The blessed philanthropy, thy social hands, had linked deserved worlds in brothers' bands. Careless if colour or if clime divide, then loved and loving man had lived and died. The purest wreaths which hang on glory's shrine, the empire's founded peaceful pen are thine. No blood-stained laurels crowned thy virtuous toil, no slaughtered natives drench thy fair-earned soil. Still thy meek spirit in thy flock survives, consistent still, their doctrine rule their lives. Thy followers only have effaced the shame inscribed by slavery on the Christian name. Shall Britain, where the soul of freedom reigns, forge chains for others she herself disdains? Forbid it, heaven! Oh, let the nations know the liberty she loves, she will bestow. Not to herself the glorious gift confined, she spreads the blessing wide as humankind. And, scorning narrow views of time and place, bids all be free in earth's extended space. What page of human annals can record a deed so bright as human rights restored? Oh, may that godlike deed, that shining page, redeem our fame and consecrate our age. And see the cherub, mercy from above, descending softly, quits the sphere of love. On feeling hearts she sheds celestial dew, and breathes her spirit o'er the enlightened few. From soul to soul the spreading influence steals, till every breast the soft contagion feels. She bears exulting to the burning shore the loveliest office angel ever bore. To vindicate the power in heaven adored, to still the clank of chains and sheathe the sword, to cheer the mourner and with soothing hands from bursting hearts unbind the oppressor's bands, to raise the lustre of the Christian name and clear the foulest blot that dims its fame. As the mild spirit hovers over the coast, a fresher hue the withered landscapes boast. Her healing smiles the ruined scenes repair, and blasted nature wears a joyous air. She spreads her blessed commission from above, stamped with the sacred characters of love. She tears the banner stained with blood and tears, and liberty, thy shining standard, rears. As the bright ensign's glory she displays, see pale oppression faints beneath the blaze. The giant dies, no more his frown appalls. The chain untouched drops off, the fetter falls. Astonished echo tells the vocal shore, oppression's fallen and slavery is no more. The dusky myriads crowd the sultry plain and hail that mercy long invoked in vain. Victorious power, she burst their toefold bands, and faith and freedom spring from mercy's hands.